Jelaluddin Muhammad Rumi is a Muslim poet who was born in present-day Afghanistan in the year 1207 and died aged 66 in the year 1273. Rumi began life as a teacher and scholar, but his life changed forever when he met the wandering Sufi Shams of Tabriz on the 15th of November 1244. Shams became, in modern parlance, but more literally than that, Rumi's soulmate. Shams disappeared, possibly killed, possibly by Rumi's jealous son, in 1248. Obviously, Rumi was heartbroken. He went on an unsuccessful quest to find Shams. Eventually, he came to the mystical conclusion that they hadn't been separated. Shams was everywhere, just as God was everywhere and in all things. At this point, it might be worth explaining a few things. It's common to hear nowadays that Islam is intolerant, conservative, and backward-looking. That's partly because Saudi Arabia and Iran have oil wealth and they've managed to use it to impress their highly conservative versions of Islam on the Muslim world and on Western media. But it wasn't always like that. Sufism goes back to the very beginnings of Islam and it always had a much more inclusive vision of the world, inclusive of women, inclusive of music and dancing, inclusive of wine. There's a lot of drunkenness in Rumi. Inclusive of other religions. It tends to see them all as being roots to one God. Sikhism, one of the most enlightened of the world's great religions, probably began in a fusion of Sufi Islam and Hinduism in the 15th century. It too tends to see all religions as being roots to one God. What happened when Rumi met Shams has been a subject of much speculation among scholars. According to Will Johnson's 2003 book, The Spiritual Practices of Rumi, the two men simply sat and gazed into each other's eyes for a long, long time. This is a mystical technique that's often been practiced elsewhere, the Western esoteric tradition, for example, and it's sometimes called tantric eye-gazing. The word tantric has sexual overtones in modern Western discourse, but it doesn't really mean anything like that. It really refers to magical practices, often involving visual aids such as mandalas. All of Rumi's poems, and there are a lot of them, focus on the same theme, the oneness of the self, the divine and the whole created order. If you want to read them in English, then in my view, his best English translator is Coleman Barks. I can't affirm that for certain, however, I don't know any Persian. All I know is that Barks did it for me, as they say.